We have just entered the 14th day of Iceland's eruption of the Reykjanes volcano, located 20 miles southwest of the capital of Reykjavik. Despite all indications suggesting that this eruption would have ended by now, it has not. Instead, for the first time in many months, the singular erupting spatter cone has entered a cycle of increasing and decreasing lava effusion and lava fountaining. 2 to 4 of these cycles are now occurring on a daily basis, where during a multi-hour long low point, no lava effusion is visible, with an occasional orange glow, while during high points, more vigorous lava fountaining and spattering is easily visible. Thus, each time this eruption enters a quiet period, it could truly represent the end of its 9th eruption since 2023, or it could just represent the end of another cycle that will soon have lava spattering pop back up again. You may have noticed a secondary vent emerge on the western side of the now more than 30 meter tall and 135 meter wide spatter cone. This vent almost certainly links to the primary vent at the top of the cone, probably having formed due to rising lava within the crater pushing outward to the side that happened to find a weak point in the cooling lava. So far, across 14 days, a total of 27.3 million cubic meters of molten rock has erupted, spanning an area of 3.84 square kilometers or 1.48 square miles. I have highlighted the new area in red, which was untouched by prior 21st century eruptions which were covered in lava from the ongoing eruption. This new area totals 1.34 square kilometers or 331 acres. Lava is currently advancing slowly in two directions, to the southeast and to the north-northeast. The southeast lava flow has filled in some recently formed kipukas or islands surrounded by lava and is now heading south due to redirection from the higher walls of the neighboring Fagradalfjall complex's volcanic rock to the east. As for the north-northeast lobe, lava is arcing counterclockwise to the north due to being redirected that way due to a low prominence incline to the east and northeast. Either of these flows could theoretically advance another kilometer or so, but I honestly do not expect lava to travel much further than this due to the absurdly low lava effusion rate at the present. While the average lava effusion has been 24.31 cubic meters per second in the first 2 weeks, I pin the current lava effusion rate as only around 10 cubic meters per second, possibly even lower than this. This has created a lava field of varying thicknesses, albeit averaging 7.1 meters or 23.3 feet thick. There has been a lot of talk lately about not only these lava flows, but also the other ones nearby which look deceptively cool. A few incidents of bad tourist behavior have occurred, and I hope the explanation behind each incident is simply ignorance. You see, lava flows take an absurdly long time to cool, which increases the thicker they get. Here is a chart the US Geological Survey made for the Kilauea volcano, which should be applicable to Iceland's Reykjanes volcano. Since lava flows are up to 45 meters thick in some spots from a combination of prior eruptions, they will take at least 15 years to cool. And I don't mean cool completely, just for the hottest part of the lava flow to cool to a temperature of 200 degrees Celsius or 392 degrees Fahrenheit, which, as you might have guessed, can still easily cause a severe burn. Thus, you should never walk on any fresh or recent lava flows, as they could easily be still molten underneath, and since lava flows contract as they cool, random subsidence can occur that causes underlying lava tubes to collapse, and you would not want to be standing above when that happened. I personally think that at least one additional eruption of the Reykjanes volcano will occur either in the latter part of 2025 or early 2026, as once again the Reykjanes volcano's magma chamber is recharging, causing uplift. However, this is occurring at a rate 11% lower than observed 2 months ago, indicating a declining input. Also, a clarification. The Blue Lagoon and the town of Grindavik are both open at the present to tourists. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, Astrid Mullenberg, for supporting my work.